In this tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to create a button symbol in Adobe Flash. A button symbol is a unique type of symbol that has four different states that let people know when they're hovering over a button and when they've clicked on a button and what area of the button is active. So let's preview our animation and see what kind of buttons that we can create. I'll do Command Return or Control Enter on a PC. Okay, so with this animation, as you can see, it automatically started the minute I previewed this video. It didn't give me a chance to click and say play, and then at the same time, it stops, and then it just sits there. So I can add two buttons to my project. I can add a button to the beginning that's gonna allow the person to choose when it should start playing, and I can add a button to the end that allows it to replay. And I can even add a button that's gonna mute the sound. For now, we're just gonna create one button for the replay action. The first thing you need to do for a button is make sure that it has its own layer. So I'll go ahead and call this layer replay BTN for button. I made sure that all of my other layers were locked so that it didn't interfere with them in any way. Now, the first time that you create a layer, it's going to create one layer that's as long as the longest part of your animation, and the first frame on that layer is going to be a blank keyframe because it assumes you want to add content to the first frame of that new layer. However, because this is a replay button, I could have added, if this was, let's say, the start button, then I do want that button to appear on the first frame. But unfortunately, this is the replay button, so I want it to only appear on the very last frame of my animation. So I need to add a blank keyframe here. I'll go to Insert, Timeline, and Blank Keyframe, or F7 on your keyboard as a shortcut. So now I have a blank keyframe on that layer that I can start creating my button with. Now, here's one way that you can make buttons. You can go to the Window menu, Common Libraries, and choose Buttons. And when you open that up, it has a lot of different pre-made buttons that Adobe Flash has already created for you. So if I toggle down with the buttons oval, we have a blue button and a gold button, and I have a rectangle bevel aqua, rectangle flat blue. So it's gonna try to create some stylized buttons for you, and you can change the text on those buttons. And sometimes it'll even have the up, over, down, and hit states on those buttons for you. But we're going to create our own. This is just an option for you if you need it. We're going to create our own. So I'll go ahead and click on that keyframe, that very last keyframe of my replay button layer. And I'm going to grab a shape. So I'll do the rectangle. And let's say I want to make it about 15 rounded edges. And I'm going to do kind of a hot pink. And because this is a kid's animation, I'm going to make it really easy for them to press this button and read this button. So I'll make it really big. And I can move it around if I need to. And that's the start of my button. And I probably want to add a stroke so it's a little bit more defined from the outside edges. So my button's going to include both a shape and text. It could just be text, but you have to make sure that that text is still easy to click for people. So now that I've got my shape down, I'll grab my text tool and I'll change this to, let's do chalk duster and white to coordinate, and I'll type replay. And it looks like that's right aligned, so I'll do center and make it much bigger. And try to line it up. Oops, let's go ahead and make, I have a bunch of different settings here from a previous project. So now I have my replay button ready to convert to a button symbol. So I need to make sure that I select both the shape and the text that make up that button so I can click and then hold shift and then click the second object and it'll highlight both of them. And go to modify and convert to symbol. Now I need to change this to button, and I'm going to call this BTN replay. this is how I always name my symbols. I always give myself a couple of letters to show me what kind of symbol this is. So it's either BTN or GFC for graphic or MC for movie clip. And then the first letter of every word after that is capitalized, and I make sure to name it a specific name so I know what button this is. I'll click OK, and now this has been converted into a symbol. If I go into the library panel, you can see I have the button replay symbol here. I can click here and do the up, over, down, and hit state, but I actually like to see it in context with the rest of the graphics around it. So with that symbol selected on the stage, I can double click, and now you can see I'm in that button inside of scene one, and my timeline has up, over, down, and hit states. This means that when it's up, when a mouse is not over the button, it's going to be pink and it's going to have the word replay. When a mouse hovers over it, I want to change the color or the way it looks. So I want it to be the exact same size, the exact same shape, the exact same font. I just want to change the color. So instead of trying to remake all of this, I'm going to hit F6 on my keyboard, which is the same thing as doing insert, timeline, keyframe. And it's going to copy whatever content was on the keyframe right before it. So it made a copy of that pink square and that replay text. Now all I have to do is click on that shape and change the color. And that's a little bit crazy. So I can go ahead and do that. And then my down state, I can hit F6 again. And go ahead and change maybe the background for this one. I want it to be blue. Okay. And then the hit state is the active area of that button. So you want it to be at least as big as the entire button and the text it contains. And if you want it to be a tiny bit bigger, this button's already huge anyway, so it's not necessary. But if you had a tiny little button down here, probably want to make it a little bit bigger for people who have problems with the mobility of their hands. But otherwise, this hit state, I can create a new hit state that's based on the shape, but if you don't put anything there, it's going to take whatever shape was in the down, so we'll just leave it like this. So we'll go back, and let's go ahead and do Control, Enable Simple Buttons, and now you can see when I'm off of the button, it's that regular pink, and when I hover over it, it turns green, and my mouse changes to a hand icon. And then when I click, that's the down state, so when it's pressed down, it turns to that bluish teal color. So that gives the user an indication that this is an interactive button that they can click. And the hit state allows it so that even if I get this close to the button, it doesn't change. The hit state is the exact shape that the button made, so as soon as I touch it, it starts to change. Now, this button's not finished. It doesn't do anything. It's just a graphic right now. What we need to do is we need to add action script that tells it when somebody clicks on this button, it should go back to the start of the movie and play it again. We'll get into that in the tutorial video on action script 2.0. and another tutorial on ActionScript 3.0, so you can see the difference in the same button between the ActionScript styles.